had to have a little bit of fun. So for this video, I'm mostly going to be taking y'all through the workouts that me and my trainer have been doing and some of the methods. So jump rope has been a huge part of my training at this point for a number of reasons. Part of it is cardio, the other part is endurance, and yeah, it's just, it's cool, but it's definitely a challenge. It definitely switched things up for me. And so now I'm about to get into these lunges, these curtsy lunges, and I love and I hate them.
One ass is not the same, sorry.
Yeah, pretty much. I have struggled with my glutes ever since my lower back injury, so that's a thing. Okay, so I must say that posing was probably one of the hardest parts of training and preparing for contest prep. And it's just, it's different. It's different from what I'm used to. And I'm used to striking maybe a pose for a moment with dancing. I have a background in dancing, so I thought, yeah, you know, this posing stuff is gonna be easy. It isn't. It isn't at all. I am very much struggling. Here goes me walking in with some T-Rex arms, as they finally call them. And I think part of it was seeing myself just, you know, in a bikini, you know, very little clothing and so on and so forth. But I also feel like, goodness, this was hard for me, just understanding how you walk and then pose. It very much is like modeling, and I think I might have said that before in another video, but oh my goodness, y'all. So my posing coach is helping me work on my T-walk, which is how in this contest you're supposed to come out. You're supposed to come out, strike a pose, walk down, strike a pose, go to your left, go to your right, come back to middle, turn around, show your back pose, which I think I'm about to attempt to get into now. Yeah, so here goes me trying to figure out my back pose and trying to figure out which part of it works best for me. So I'm not even getting into like any of the very like cute and playful aspects. I am just trying to lock it down, and ooh, the struggle is so real. Excuse this noise in the background if this is coming through. Hopefully it's not too loud, but I'm gonna speak up. And yeah, this is what it is like when you are on stage. You do your little routine, and yes, your training is also important, but if I'm not mistaken, half of the score is posing, so it's pretty crucial.
Is it actually raining, or is that just mist? How much I long for rain.
Right now,
we're gonna get your ass going.
Right now, you guys can't see, but this is heavy as fuck right now. 10 and 10, is it?
5 and 5.
All right, so back to the streets. I'm doing these overhead presses, 5 and 5 presses, yep, and 5 kickbacks. It's harder than it looks, even though the weight is lightweight. We are trying to do it kind of quickly. Again, at this point, we're on a shred protocol, so I'm not lifting too heavy, but the speed makes up for it. You will see.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, y'all didn't even want to see that face. It was so ugly.
Yeah.
Oh, wee.
Not gonna lie to y'all, I love these bent over rows. The most important part to me though is the setup. I didn't take too much time, but this is probably my second or third set. Without a weightlifting belt, it can get tricky. Just positioning myself in a way so that I don't hurt my back is important, but I love the way these feel.
Really?
You know how to do something.
Alright, so here I go. Posing, homework, posing, part two. And I guess I'm feeling a little bit more comfortable with it, but it's still pretty awkward, which I think third time's a charm. And now I'm just sort of doing these like la 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 arm exercises because I'm trying to like loosen up and just sort of ease and gracefully get into my pose.
There you go. Get that foot up there, landing. There you go.
This was so funny.
I like my mountain climbers too. The low ones, the high ones. I feel it in my lower back. I feel it in my glutes, my legs, my abs, my arms. Being silly, but yeah, I really enjoy doing them and in conjunction with any type of compound leg exercise, so squats or deadlift. It feels like it gives me a good warm up, and my glutes and hips are definitely the kind that needs a really good warm up in order for them to activate.
Nice. So one thing I want you to think about whenever you're setting up for your deadlifts or your squats, foot placement. Try to make sure you have the same foot placement every time. That's good. Stand up straight, don't arch back. There you go. Squeeze those glutes. Have them. There you go. Good. Nice.
And look at me now.
So if y'all don't know by now, I'm silly AF. I love laughing and joking during these workouts, so I hope you're also maybe a little silly too, and enjoy it and appreciate it. If not, don't worry about it. The whole "and look at me now" is basically me saying it's August, y'all. I'm getting more serious. I took for granted some of the dietary aspects, and I know everyone's gonna be like, that's what prep is all about. I get it. Lot going on for me right now in life, and at times it's probably one of the hardest things in the world for me to do. So now that it's August and I'm seeing, you know, the time get to it, I'm seeing just how important it is. And yeah, in August, I was definitely taking it a lot more seriously. And you can kind of tell from my physique, I do believe, quite a transformation that has taken place from July to August, or even from May to now, August. An ongoing issue for me continues to be this lower back and glute activation on my left side, my hip, all the way into my psoas, was injured a couple years back from some car accidents, a couple car accidents, and it's pretty devastating. And part of the reason that I was really committed to doing this contest was to work through some of that within my body, within my training. And I'm really proud of myself. I'm really proud of how far I've come along with this. And just trying to make sure that I take some extra time to care for myself, because honestly, it just gets to that point where you wonder, like, if you don't do it now, and in particular, I'm talking about like caring for my injuries. If I don't do it now, then what will it look like in 5 years? What will it look like in 10 years? So part of this process was committing to a training that would keep me on point.
I need to stretch more. I'm not stretching enough. That didn't used to be me. All I used to do is stretch. It was like the opposite side of the pendulum.
That's a 12-pound head, so there you go. There you go, buddy.
Ouch.
Don't hit yourself.
Stop hitting yourself.
That's why we don't slam sledgehammers anymore. People were like fucking their legs up.
That would have been me. I can't even laugh at anyone else be like, that totally would have been me killing myself.
Like on tires, people would miss the tire and bah! People straight snapping ankles. Let's go.
I was telling you what would happen to me. I'm so glad I missed that era.
I did mention I'm silly, right? No, but for real. If I was sledgehammering to this day, I would have fucked up like my toes, my knees, my shins, probably somebody else's. But yeah, I guess this is a version of that, and it's really good for the lats. So not this one I'm doing, but the previous exercise, that slam one. So yep. So I guess this is the portion where I want to give a shout out to my trainer, Osa, for being awesome. Because, yeah, when I go and I train and I work out on my own, I'm so deeply focused on certain areas of my body. I'm not aware or even conscious of how I am underdeveloped in certain other places and how that's going to have an impact on my body and my overall training. So doing things like upper body exercises, particularly curls or these little exercises here, these little, I guess, presses, overhead presses, sit-ups. Well, I did sit-ups, but push-ups and planks and, you know, just a lot of things that are stabilizing for the core. I was never going to do those on my own. So thank you so much. For those folks that are out there training for a contest and it's your first one, I know it takes a huge amount of discipline to be able to work the areas of your body that you're not used to working or don't feel comfortable doing on your own. So this is where I will say, if you can afford it, I truly recommend getting a trainer like my awesome one.
Ready? So the presses are first, overhead is second, and then taking it down for the... Not sure why I did it like that, but it made me feel good.
I think it was Prince. I blame Prince.
I'll take that. Nice. Wait for it.
It's a lot heavier than it looks.
I like that you say that after you just been pressing it.
That's different.
True. Whistle.
Whistle while you twerk.
Ugh, I hate that song so much.
Go ahead and start it. Make the pussy fart. Twerk some.
I hated that song so much. It was a song that when it would come on, I just did like make the worst thing.
You know that song had Black Friday, Black Saturday explosion cracking?
Oh, you do.
What's the muscles that lift it?
Lift what?
Above my head.
Let's see, the serratus anterior helps, but it's also mainly the delts and the upper back. So we have a little bit of trap in there, some rhomboid.
Shit is not strong.
That's why we're doing it. There you go, bring that thing down.
So this is secretly another one of my favorite warm-ups and exercises, the slam ball. I love it for the same reason that I love the, I want to call it running man, whatever that, mountain climbers for glute activation. So it is such a powerhouse when it comes to glute activation.
My calves.
Yeah. It's the only way to open everything up, though. Let's go.
Girl, them calves is on hurt right now. I did some added calf exercises in my program yesterday, and ow. So at this point, I'm definitely feeling away. I do not train to silence. I do not train to outside noises and birds chirping. I don't even train to the music that they play at the gym. I need selected tunes to keep me motivated, and I'm kind of tight with my trainer right now because he has not put on the music. And that's why when he asked me if I was ready, I said no, because you know how I get down. I need some music. Yeah, so it's kind of a miracle that I got through all of that, but yeah. I think I also didn't sleep good. I'm just like looking at the expression on my face and I'm like, I didn't sleep good and you're not gonna have the music right. What are you trying to do to me? Now he wants to put on the music. Okay, cool. So I figured out what was going on with me when I saw this clip of me with the mask on. It smelled like burning rubber or something. And, you know, we're in California, so we deal with wildfires. So it seems that there was a fire burning. And myself figured, let me put on a mask because that's going to make, you know, me be able to. I don't even know. But yeah. It backfired. The smoke ends up getting caught in the mask, which sucked. There was really no escaping it that day. Just kind of sucked. So, in other news, we are really getting to it on this leg day, glute day workout. Probably my favorite day. And we are doing hip thrusts, which I love. Number one, well, I love these deadlifts as well. They're a little bit easier for me to do. I don't feel the same result from them as when I do a hip thrust, but I do feel like I can achieve good form while doing them. And then we were also doing some exercises on the box, which again, that glute activation is everything for me, and my trainer knows it. So yeah.
Use those glutes to push it up. There you go. Are you ready?
Yep.
Let's get it, babe. Yeah. Oh, we're back in the ballet slippers.
She's slipping.
Like, all right.
It's the curtsy and then the jump.
Curtsy and then jump work, yes, ma'am. Eyes up. Nice. Yeah. There you go. Nice.
So just going to jump in here one more time and give a shout out to my trainer, because while I've been able to do some of these exercises at home, just from reviewing my videos and seeing the difference in my training sessions with my trainer, being held to time and being accountable to time is something that separates your training. So you might train hard, but the breaks that you take in between activations are perhaps too long. And I know that's the case for me. I might be intense during a lift, but then right after the lift, I'm taking a huge break. And so just appreciating the timekeeping and the ability to stay on point and on track in my training session, because you know, you might know exactly what to do. You might know how many times to do it. You may even have really good form, but if you don't keep time for yourself, your training session might end up being 2 hours as opposed to 1 hour or 45 minutes.
I don't know about y'all, but 2 hours is too much time in the gym. There's so many more things that you can be doing with that time. You can be prepping a meal, eating a meal, recovering, taking a bath, going on a walk, stretching. You know, I think that if you go to the gym one time, or maybe two times a week, and you spend an hour and a half, 2 hours, then maybe that's okay for you because you're not going often. But at this point, I'm training every single day. So that extra hour is critical for me. So this is just one of the things that I was reflecting on around the importance and the value of having a trainer versus doing it on your own. I don't know if I could do it on my own. Maybe one day I might try, but just knowing me and how my life works, I'm probably going to need to pay a trainer. So it's just something to think about while you're prepping and doing your own journey. Let me know. Are y'all training on your own? Have you tried? What's the big difference that you see? And yeah, just share it with us. And appreciate y'all for watching. See you in the next one. Peace.